Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today I'm talking about the what, why, and the when of dermal filler injections. Let's start with the what. So what is being used out there? There's basically four different types, if you think about it, that's commonly used. Number one are the gel fillers, commonly hyaluronic acid fillers. That's the most common. Those are dissolvable. The second type would be the collagen stimulators. Those are things like Sculptra, which is PLLA, or Belafil in this country, which is PMMA, and they're injectables also through a syringe the same way. However, they stimulate collagen and typically are longer lasting. They can be used to not only thicken the dermis, make the skin better, but also create angles and structure. The third, I'm going to include PDO threads here because a lot of people will use the term I'm injecting threads, and they're quite right because threads are often PDO, polydioxinone, or PLLA, similar to Sculptra, which is a liquid water, but in a thread form, and really you're injecting them. They can be smooth or they can be barbed, which give you a little more of a lift versus the smooth, which just build the collagen, but you don't get that barb lift like you do with the barb sutures. And those are used a little differently than fillers, but that would be third in the category. I'm also going to include the fourth, which are blood products, and those are injected. Think of PRP or the new generation platelet-rich fiber. And I'm going to put some videos in the description below on PRF to tell you more about that, but we'll include that as well. The important thing to know about these, they all work together and they're all tools in your injector's portfolio to create a beautiful look. Whether it's projection, better skin, or glow, often all those things are used together. It's not one thing. So when you go in for fillers, all those things come into play. So why are these injectables used? Well, there's three main reasons. Very commonly now, people are creating. So they're creating a higher cheek, a chin projection, a jawline. They're getting better skin. But you can create things with them, and depending on what you're trying to create will depend which of those tools is used more. Rejuvenating would be the second reason that people do them. Now, when we talk about rejuvenation, we're really talking about typically someone older, or one of the most important caveats is older skin, because it doesn't go by age or chronological age, but more so what the skin's been exposed to, the genetics of the skin, smoking, exogenous factors, pollution. The other why is preventing. And I think this is the most important thing that we can do for our patients. And as aesthetic providers, we do this every day, from topical sunscreen to discouraging smoking to telling people to eat right and exercise and all those great things. But injectables do prevent. But this is one where I think it's important to have a physician or injector that you trust to guide you along. Third, we'll address when. This is a tough one because we know, and we look at the demographics on this YouTube channel, the most people that watch it are around age 22 to about 40, whereas before it used to be 45 plus. So the young people definitely want to come in, and I call that, at the beginning of young at least, prevention. So prevention is absolutely key, and we can start younger, but again, you don't want to do the things that won't be preventive. You don't want to be sold something that's not going to provide you a long-term benefit, and potentially doing longer-term collagen stimulators could be unsafe at a young age because there's many years left to live, and that filler, those products are going to be exposed to everything your body is for a long time. So prevention is something that's important to be advised about. But starting early absolutely does help if it's appropriately done. So prevention's typically early. Now we'll talk about, say, midlife. Particularly here, we look at the females because 45 to 55, we see a dramatic hormonal change. And this determines what we need to do. In this stage, it's not uncommon for people to come in, do all of the treatments I talked about in terms of injectables, and still feel like after a year or two, they haven't done that much. And it's because of the change in bone, the change in redistribution in fat, and the thinning of the skin due to the estrogen loss. So at this stage, prevention is always important, but we're more so rejuvenating, providing structure, and looking forward a few years. The final stage is people presenting kind of later or more advanced. And this is common because these treatments, A, they weren't readily available, socially acceptable, people weren't comfortable getting them, and they didn't know what to do. It's much more known now. But when people show up 55, 65 plus, we'll just use a general term, a lot of times there's enough laxity in the skin, enough fat that is redistributed or hypertrophy grown, that a facelift might be more appropriate first. A lot of times surgery is then followed by all the other treatments that we do, because you have to imagine people are catching up from 30 or 40 years of skin damage, bone loss, muscle changes. And so it's a sticker shock, and it's a shock to people, but waking up at a later stage and then taking care of the skin, as you can imagine, we have a lot of catching up to do. And this is at the point where the provider will typically look and say, yes, we can do it. Here's what I guesstimate it will be. Or we can fine tune a few areas and improve, or get surgery first if that suits somebody. So that's a little bit about what products are available, kind of what can be done, and then when to do them. Certainly the general theme, prevent, find a good provider to advise you on what to do, and starting earlier rather than later with appropriate treatments is a key element. So pop over to our Instagram at RajaniMD Skincare. We have a lot of great discussions and before and afters over there. Join us here on this YouTube channel, subscribe. You can click a button below. Also comment, let us know what you think of this and our other videos in the comments section below. And in the description, I'll include links to what I've talked about. Thanks for joining me today. Join us in this channel for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.